1997. We just passed a guy in a jetpack.
American 1997, okay, thank you. Were they off to your left side or right side?
Off the left side, maybe 300 yards or so, about our altitude.
Okay, American 1997, contact tower 120.905, thanks today.
120.905, we'll see you,
American 1997. And Skyway 360, we just saw the guy pass by us, jetpack.
JetBlue 23, use caution. Person in a jetpack reported 300 yards south of the LA final at about 3,000 feet, 10 mile final.
JetBlue 23, we're heard, and we're definitely looking.
Only in LA.
At around 6:35 p.m. on Sunday the 30th of August 2020, an American Airlines Airbus was making a routine flight from Philadelphia to Los Angeles when the pilot noticed something strange. During his final approach towards the runway, he reported a person in a jetpack at around 3,000 feet, 10 miles east of the airport, and about 300 yards left of the plane. Another pilot in a separate plane, flying north of the American Airlines flight, also confirmed seeing the jetpack pass their aircraft as they circled LAX. This prompted the air traffic control tower to alert authorities, including the FBI and FAA, who conducted an immediate investigation. Whilst the act of owning and flying a jetpack isn't illegal, without FAA approval, they can only be flown during the day and are barred from flying over densely populated areas and controlled airspaces. After extensive searches over the next few days, nothing was found, and speculation grew over who the elusive aeronaut was.
The FAA and FBI are investigating a startling report of what they're calling an airspace intruder, a man wearing a jetpack.
It wasn't long, however, before they would be spotted again over the skies of LA. This time by a China Airlines pilot on the 14th of October at around 1:45 p.m.
So how about China C-060, we just saw the flying object at the 6,000.
China C-006 Heavy, can you say that one more time, please?
We just saw the flight object, like a flight suit, just passing by at 6,000.
Flying object, was it a UAV or was it a jetpack?
Like a jetpack, too shiny, too fast.
That is 006 Heavy, Roger, thank you.
The air traffic controller contacted a law enforcement aircraft in the area, Idaho 30, to go and check out the reported sighting. But neither they nor any other planes in the vicinity reported seeing the jetpack. Understandably, this sparked many people's interests, but it also became a massive concern for authorities due to the dangers of a person flying so close to a busy airport. As speculation continued to grow, a YouTuber by the name of AirRack actually managed to trick the mainstream news media into believing that they had witnessed another sighting of the jetpack man in November, using superimposed footage of a person landing on one of the hangars at LAX. Whilst this was confirmed as a clever prank, the actual sightings were very real. And with the mystery still ongoing, a month later, on the 21st of December 2020, an instructor from a Los Angeles pilot academy recorded this. The pilot recorded the video whilst in his own private plane and claimed he had never seen anything like it. The jetpack was flying at 3,000 feet over the ocean off the coast of Palos Verdes, roughly 7 miles from LAX. This was the first time that the jetpack man had been caught on camera, that is, according to most news sources. I managed to do some digging and found this post by a Reddit user who believes he may have captured footage of the jetpack man 4 months earlier on the 15th of August 2020. Whilst the video isn't as clear, it certainly looks like it could be a person in a jetpack, so there's every possibility that this could have been the first recorded images of the mysterious man. The location of the video was taken at Echo Park, looking towards Los Angeles National Forest, which is roughly 40 miles northwest of LAX. It's hard to tell if this is the jetpack man, but the sighting is in the same area and it fits the timeline, so there's every chance that it is. Despite these sightings captured on camera, authorities still had no leads on who this was or where they were going to pop up next. They would have to wait 7 months for Jetpack Man to return, and on the 28th of July 2021, at roughly 6:15 p.m, he was back at LAX.
Was he off your left or right, sir?
Right wing.
Roger. And do you know what altitude?
About 5,000.
Roger.
Skyway 3626, use caution. The jet man is back. Let me know if you see him.
All right. We'll be looking. Where is he?
And last reported 5,000 by that heavy 7-4 ahead and to the left. Skyway 3626, did you see the a UFO?
Yeah, we were looking, but we did not see Iron Man. Skyway 3626.
Alaska 233, use caution. There was a jet man reported just north of gate. He was last reported at 5,000.
All right, we're looking for the Iron Man, Alaska 233.
As you may suspect, they once again weren't caught. And from the pilot's tone of voice, it seems as though some have already had enough of this stunt. Nobody to this day has managed to come close to figuring out who this person is. And with the latest event as recent as July 2021, it's likely that this isn't the last reported sighting of the so-called LA Iron Man. So who is the Jetpack Man? How is it that authorities can't find him? And importantly, why is he flying so dangerously close to LAX? Well, before we get into the theories of who this could be, it's important to understand both the history and capabilities of this technology, as well as who the current leading companies are in the market. Whilst the idea of a real-life Iron Man seems unlikely, jetpack technology has actually existed for quite some time, with the first ever design developed in 1919 by Soviet inventor Alexander Andreev. Intended for use as a military aerial reconnaissance vehicle, a patent was issued for the development of the so-called knapsack rocket device, but apparently it was never built. The world would have to wait until 1961 for the first public flight in a jetpack, or rocket belt, when Bell Aerosystems showcased the Bell No. 2 rocket belt to US President John F. Kennedy and over 3,000 military personnel at the Pentagon. The military were initially keen on using the technology as a way of gaining a tactical advantage on the battlefield, with the idea that combat soldiers could use them to overcome obstacles such as minefields. Due to its limited flight duration and other logistical issues, the idea was scrapped, and the rocket belts were instead used for more entertainment and recreational purposes. In 1984, William Souter, nicknamed Rocket Man, famously flew a Bell rocket belt in the opening ceremony of the Los Angeles Olympics, and the world became transfixed on the idea that jetpacks were the future of aviation. Fast forward 35 years to 2021, and whilst they aren't yet a common mode of public transport, jetpack technology has advanced considerably, with companies like Gravity and Jetpack Aviation having created multiple variations of their inventions over the years. Jetpack Aviation are one of the leading players in the jetpack game, with their most recent model, the JB11, considered to be one of the most advanced jetpacks ever built. Utilizing the power of six small turbojet engines, the JB-11 is capable of flying over 120 miles per hour at heights of up to 15,000 feet for up to 12 minutes. This model was publicly unveiled back in 2018 at the Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas and flown by the CEO of Jetpack Aviation himself, David Maimon. So, back to the mystery. When you look at the images captured of Jetpack Man, it certainly flies similar to the JB models from Jetpack Aviation, and also possibly the jet suit from its competitor, Gravity. It certainly doesn't fly or resemble any other models I've found, such as these more winged versions from Frenchman Vince Raffet and Swiss Yves Rossi. Jetpack Man was seen flying at heights of up to 6,000 feet for no longer than a few minutes at a time, and was situated solely in Los Angeles. Considering this, and knowing the capabilities of Jetpack Aviation, who themselves are based in LA, the immediate thought that comes to mind is that this must be one of their jetpacks. Even older models, like the JB-9, have been said to be able to theoretically reach heights of 15,000 feet for up to 8 minutes. When questioned by the LA Times about the stunt, Maimon quickly ruled out the jetpack being one of his, as the company, along with its competitors, don't sell to consumers. Despite both current available models, the JB-10 and JB-11, being priced at $250,000 and $300,000 respectively, they are only currently available for purchase by the US military. So could Jetpack Man be a pilot from the US military? Or could one of their jetpacks have been stolen? Well, again, Maimon states that he knows exactly where all of his company's jetpacks are, and they are disabled when not in use, so grabbing a pack out of storage wouldn't be possible. Plus, if the military were testing these jetpacks, they wouldn't have much reason to trial these out in the open at one of their country's busiest airports, endangering not only themselves, but the lives of those on passenger airplanes. Even if someone managed to get their hands on one of these jetpacks and got it to work, Maimon believes that the feats that this supposed jetpack is reaching far exceeds what has been achieved previously. Despite claiming that his jetpacks can reach up to 15,000 feet, he states that, because of fuel constraints, they can actually reach only about 1,000 or 1,500 feet off the ground safely. To fly up to 6,000 feet from the ground, long enough to be seen by China Airlines and then descend again, you'd be out of fuel. So, if it's not one of David Maimon's or another company's jetpacks, then whose is it? After the second sighting by the Chinese Airlines flight, Maimon mentioned how the weekend incident got us all wondering whether there's been someone working in skunkworks on this. Skunkworks meaning a slang term for secret project. It may not be impossible that someone has created the technology to outperform the current leading jetpack capabilities in secret, and has managed to improve on the work of David Maimon and others. But with the costs, time and experience needed to design, build and fly one of these suits being so extreme, it seems somewhat far-fetched. Jetpack Aviation have spent the best part of 10 years crafting and perfecting their machines. And to think that a single man could have outperformed the feats of an entire company that has dedicated so much energy into this industry makes me think that this theory is unlikely. For this to be a sole individual, it would surely have to take a person with considerable wealth and a history in aviation, who has somehow managed to avoid detection from locals. That's not to say that it's not possible, but the fact that nobody has witnessed this person take off and land discredits the theory further. Jetpacks are not only something that are easy to spot, they are also incredibly loud. So it's likely that if this was a real person in a jetpack, they would be heard in the surrounding area during their flight. Since this hasn't happened, it leads on to the next theory, which is certainly one of the more popular ones amongst aviation experts. many believe that this mysterious UFO could actually be a drone, built to be the shape of a person. Masked drones already exist, such as this one suitably titled Mannequin. Built by Ralph Kayser, this model was flown in Germany in August 2019 and can supposedly fly up to 8 minutes on lithium polymer batteries, weighing just under 5 kilograms. It's also very quiet compared to the sounds of two turbojet engines, so it explains how nobody has heard it during takeoff. Not much is known about the limitations of Mannequin, other than its weight and build, so it's hard to determine whether or not it could reach heights of up to 6,000 feet. But it's certainly possible in the present day for drones to far exceed that altitude. From what I could find, Ralph seems to experiment with a number of drone-like vehicles, including gyrocopters and Segways, so he clearly has a passion in this field. I would assume from what we're seeing that this is more of a hobby for Ralph, and considering that the most recent video of him flying the gyrocopter is dated in April 2021, in what I assume to be Germany, I think we could rule out Ralph as the culprit. Drones interrupting air traffic at airports isn't an uncommon scenario, so the chances that this could be another stunt of that manner are more than plausible, and it would explain why more people aren't witnessing this. Much like the YouTube prank from earlier, it would make more sense that someone may be trying to fool the masses, in this case with a drone, especially considering how much attention it's already received. The idea of a rogue inventor creating their own jetpack in secret feels way too convoluted and written in science fiction, though I must admit that I hold on to some small chance that it could be true. In some ways, if this is the last we hear of Jetpack Man, it's probably a good thing, as the danger he poses to society through his actions outweigh the joy and wonder that come with a mystery like this, though I can't help but quietly hope that they reappear in the future and we get some sort of closure. Whatever the outcome, it's definitely one of the most interesting cases I've covered this year. And who knows, perhaps LA really does have its very own Iron Man. Thanks for watching, and I really hope you enjoyed the video. So who or what is Jetpack Man? I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. Let me know in the comments below. If you're new to the channel, hit subscribe if you're interested in stories like this. And if you enjoyed this video, please make sure you leave a like. I want to say a massive thank you to my current patrons, and also to Ripley Sterling, who helped compose the music for this video. If you've got any suggestions on any stories that you want me to cover, feel free to drop me an email or just put it in the comment section below. Thank you.